Yeah. Hello, welcome. My name is Dietmar Seifert from Augsburg, and I developed 1 year ago the Hausnummer validation. Why I try to give this program? I wanted to add addresses in my hometown, but I wanted to, at the beginning, to know when I will finish, or when we are not only one person, we are a few persons, how much we have to do to add all addresses and to have some feedback in the meantime. So we know, okay, we have now 1/3 or 2/3 of all addresses. So most people are at addresses, but they never know when they have finished in their town. And I wanted to give some hints for the people and to give motivation for them to add the address and to know when they have finished. And in the very, very far future, I have the hope that we have better data than the companies who get only the official addresses, and the official addresses are not really complete correct, because they are planning addresses. They give the government in a municipality gives address, but it can be that there is no building in the next 2 or 3 years, or they have some problems in the workflow, and there is already a building in the street which has a number, and it is not official in the data file from the government. So I asked a few companies, a few local governments in my neighborhood to give me house number lists. And after a while, also other municipality had delivered house number lists because of open data, or because other OSM mappers has requested in their own municipality. So we see in Bayern, in Bavaria, in the federal state of Bavaria, that we have small and we have bigger towns. For example, Augsburg and Munich are the bigger one, and we have some very small cities also. You see three columns, the sub-admin referenced. Is the first one, that means at least I will get a street and a number, and all numbers in the street. But it's better in a bigger city that you can also get with a file from the government in which sub-administration area it is. So it is south, west, north, east, or something, what is the official name of a sub-administration. So in Munich it is called Bezirk 3, Max Vorstadt, or what else. And this information is better that we can make smaller evaluations, and the mapper will work in the local sub-administration and not in the complete list of all Munich, where we have 150,000 addresses. The second column, geo-coordinates, means that we have very few cases where the government gives us already the geo-coordinates. This is sometimes possible because the bigger cities are the owner of the data, and they can give us the geo-coordinates, but most times they don't do, because this is a business to give the addresses with the geo-coordinates. And the addresses we could get very easy. Many governments will us give the house number lists, and if we ask them, we could try to ask if they have also the geo-coordinates for us. And the last column shows that in sometimes we also get the Postleitzahl codes from the German Postal Service. And so we can make some more validation if we have problems with the postal boundaries we have. These are the rest of the house number lists we have. So we have 26 in Germany and one in Austria. And the last 10 in the county Mettmann is the case that the OSM user, the 5, has asked the complete county Mettmann, which consists of 10 municipalities. They have completely gave us house number lists for the complete county. And this is a very good case that we have a bigger area to import, not to import, but to map the house numbers. And for the county Mettmann, I showed what was at the starting point when we got the house number list, how many addresses is in every municipality. And you see very big differences between only 4% in one municipality, and in the neighborhood we have 93%. So it is a very job of one or very few mappers who create the addresses, who maps addresses, and in only a few kilometers away, it can be a complete other situation. For example, in this county, I have in bold showed you. I will show you in bold comparable municipalities in the number of official addresses, and you see that it is the 3% against 85%. So we cannot say that in an area there we can expect that the address data is always the same. It is from one municipality to the next very different. For the small and medium municipalities with less than 100,000 citizens, I showed you the timeline, how we improve the house numbers in the municipality. It is very slow rising because mostly it depends on one or two mappers. In the bigger cities, we have a faster rise. These are the four towns where we have the house number lists with the geo-coordinates. And Würzburg in red, I made the error, I saw it last week, that I did not tell the local mappers that we have the geo-coordinates. And so it's only a job to convert the geo-coordinates, and then we can make an import. But in Berlin, we have very rise in last weeks. There is a conflict on a mailing list because we have local mappers who make a little bit import of the addresses, and we have remote mappers who didn't care or who didn't spoke with together. And so we have a conflict how to import data, mass data, if we have address available to import. So it's not so easy, and we should not import them half automatically into the database. We have to discuss before. My evaluation, my program uses a local RDBMS with Postgres and PostGIS. It is with a database OSM to PGH SQL and has area of Germany, Austria, Switzerland, Luxembourg, and Brazil. This is because I use these data for also the list of street evaluation I use on the same server, and it will be updated with minutely diffs. I have a own database for the house number application, and I have in the backend Java written as evaluation, and every municipality house number list will work two times a week. And in the front end, I use for the web page Node.js with some components. I have the code on GitHub in a private repo because the code is not very good. And we have three or four OSM members who can read it and also can make modifications or enhancement. One municipality is for me one job, and if I have sub-boundaries, I can make also for all sub-boundaries jobs, and for every job, I get all the OSM objects in the database in this area with a polygon, and get the address house number tags. And then I try, I find out if I have the street together or if not, and if I have the information about the associated street, which I don't like, but if I have the information, I can add this. I don't support only address house number objects. That means in some municipalities, the user only make address house number, and he or she belongs that that in there's only one street a few meters ago, a few meters away. So he or she expects this is the only street, and have to calculate it. But I don't make this calculation, and this is a big problem because we have about 1/3 of all addresses without address street, either with this tag or with associated street. If I have more than one address object, I take the best from lowest priority point of interest to building and to the entry of a building. If I have a house number range, I resolve it. This is in Colonia, for example, the problem that they have official house number 428. And so I have to take it at this one node or this one object as 468, because this house has these three addresses. I compare the found OSM addresses against the house number list, and so I find out identical house numbers, house numbers which only on OSM, which probably errors or very new objects, address objects, or I found the missing addresses, which we have to add in the future. And I try to interpolate the geo-coordinates for the missing house numbers with the house numbers we have already in. I show you very few pages with my evaluation. You have select complete town or some sub-admin border, and you show you see the result with for every street which number of house numbers you have already in OSM and which are missing and which are too much. And you have some options. And in red, you see striked house numbers where we have definitive found out that these house numbers are not in reality. So I can make this table editable and can say these numbers are not in reality, and I have to make a reason. And I can say this is not in the future, I will not expect this house number in the future, or I have to say this is only for a few months because there is a new construction area. You have a timeline, how the address objects increase during the time, and you have a map where you see completely for the municipality risk in color how your situation is. And you see very much blue, which is nearly or completely addressed, and the other areas, sub-admin areas, where there's still something to do. Yeah, I have some open issues, I have a lot of issues, enhancements. I want to integrate the official address coordinates we have in four municipalities. I didn't import them, but I have to use it and to give better GPX output to the user to find out where the missing house numbers are. And I have to make some better support for the list of house numbers we have more or we have not found, because this list is a feedback for the local government. We can create a list, can give it to the local government, and can say, please look at yourself if you really have these house numbers and you think that this is on the street in the on the correct position, because we didn't found it. This is a feedback channel which the government want to get also a win-win situation with us when they give us a house number list. You can view this slide later. There are only a few hints how to ask for a house number list and what options you could give the government. What we really want and what is good, a good enhancement if they can give us some geo coordinates or the postal codes. and then send it to an email with email to me, and I import it. Up to now, I don't have the possibility to give you an upload for your own. But with the number, when the number of available house number lists will increase, I will do this. And after the first evaluation, I take it into a rhythm of one or two times a week. I want to give a thank you to two contributors, Eckhard Werner, who is the administrator of my server and who made a lot of codings in the front end of the house number evaluations, and to Johannes, who made the coded, who coded the timeline chart, and to give me also hints to optimize the code. If I have two or three more minutes. I have two extensions in the slideshow. One is that I have made a try to examine how many addresses we have in Germany, because we don't have this number. I didn't find this number, and I have found out that at nearly we have 19.3 million addresses. I hope so. I expected a little bit more, so 22 to 24 million, but with this part in this time, in this kind of action I did, I found 19.3 million. And I have also the possibility, if we get the sub-administration information to every house number, but we have not the sub-administration borders, we can, if we have all addresses or most of the addresses, we can build our sub-administration borders for our own. I have checked it with a Voronoi with a Voronoi algorithm, and then we found we got one kind of sub-administration area. What is correct, but it is not so correct from the government, but it is correct in the kind that our that all addresses we have in that in OSM then in the correct sub-admin border. It is not the time now to show it. I would say this is better to stop here and to have to answer you some of your questions.
Thank you, Dietmar. Got a special relation to this talk. You don't know because I'm here from. I originate in Mettmann County, but I've not given any street addresses to OSM. I admit. So, any questions? Sorry.
On the first timeline you showed, there was several times a decrease in the completeness. Is that because there was an update of the house number list, or are there other reasons you are aware of?
Some lower?
Exactly this one. Yeah. There's a decrease in three of the rows.
I have changed sometimes the algorithm, and I made some optimization and. It was not already in the right direction, the optimization, and I have changed. The most of the thing I changed was when what is the priority to the addresses, and there I lost sometimes the real evaluation, the real goal. This is the blue one is really a really evaluation result. In this time we have we got also the geo coordinates, and we made the import prior to the start of the server, and after the time we lost some addresses. This is the normal case because some mappers kill addresses and. If they want to kill, or if they only make errors, I don't know. But also in Augsburg, where I live, we see that we lose in a quarter 30 or 40 addresses. I have up to now not the possibility to say, okay, these and these addresses I have lost, but this would be an issue for the future to see what happens between last week and today and which object IDs and so on.
I think you match addresses, street names, one-on-one, exact matches. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you looked at using something like the Levenstein distance between street names? I've looked at Luxembourg, and about 1/6 of the street names are misspelled in the reference or in OSM. So have you looked at that?
Not in the house number validation. I have enhanced my street list validation. And with Brazil, with one of 27 federal states, and there is massive problem with spelling of the streets because they come from the census, and all the people have told their street names, and you have a street up to 4 or 5 times with different spelling, and so I have have made some normalization, but not in the house number list at this time. But I could transfer the idea and the concept I have realized.
Do you have any data for Karlsruhe?
Sorry?
Do you have any data for Karlsruhe?
No. Karlsruhe is a bad place for getting lists. They have an old GIS system on the government. And I have tried earlier to get lists from Karlsruhe via the local mappers, but they didn't get the list. And we in Baden-Württemberg, you get a statewide street list, but this street list from Karlsruhe is the worst street list we have in the complete Baden-Württemberg, because you have also school names and you have places which are not official, and you have something more, because they have an old GIS system and they don't know what is a street name, what is the other name, what is the other type the name is for. So we don't get this information. But it's not my responsibility to get the list. I have, I wish that every mapper ask at his local government, because there is a better possibility to get the list if I asked it at my governor or at my local official. Because if I ask from Augsburg in Bavaria, nobody cares in north of Germany or so. And this is not my job to get as much list as possible.
So last chance for a short question and a short answer in this discussion.
Is this, yeah.
Well, it's not limited to Germany. If you have any list from other countries, please tell me.
I wanted to ask if I have the local authorities in our country are giving it on an Excel file.
A little bit slow. Sorry.
Okay. We only have an Excel file that is saying like the street name and the pair and impair numbers. Mm-hmm. It can be possible from this to use it?
You could show me the file and give it to me.
Yeah, I will after that.
And we have to know if we can use the file, if it is from the government. But if this is the case, I could import it. If it is not inside my current area, I have to make a little bit extra action. And after every 2 months, I make a complete re-import of the database, and then I expand the area. But also during this time, it is possible to make an evaluation for some municipalities which are out of my area.
So thank you, Dietmar, for the talk and the discussion.